I don't want you to lose 2 Peter. I don't want you to lose it. So I want to go back to the back part of that before I take you forward, because there's a remedy here. Now I see some of y'all smiling because I knew that some of you all knew in your spirit, at least spoke with the Holy Ghost, know that God wasn't through with that. Amen, somebody. So I think folk with the Holy Ghost knew that God wasn't quite finished with that. And I just want to get that, because I want to tell you that there are going to be, and I want you to hear this plainly, there are going to be awesome miracles behind this conference. God showed that to me last night. There's going to be awesome testimonies behind this conference. And the Lord has allowed me to know that this will be the last conference that you come in and get your breakthrough and go home and lose it. Some of y'all still treat me like an evangelist, but that's okay, because that was a prophecy right there. That was a prophecy right there. And I'm going to say it one more time. He said this will be the last conference that you will ever go to. That God will take your spirit to another level. And when you get back home, you lose it. You're not going to lose it this time, because the Holy Ghost said what is in your belly is going to hold you in position until you come into your miracle. The devil ain't stealing nothing else from you. He done stole enough. He done robbed you enough. You're going out of here with a secret today. I want you to start with me when it said, add to your faith. How many of y'all know that? That was something that really changed your life yesterday. How many know now why you have not been getting what you have been receiving? Because I had to go back to that. How many of you know that I've had the faith to believe all these years that God was going to do exactly what he said, but I didn't know why it wasn't coming to pass? And the reason why it wasn't coming to pass is because to every situation that you are believing God for, you have to add these things to that situation in order for it to come to pass. You're going to find that after this, that every time you believe God something, listen, within a matter of days, it's going to come to pass. Mother, I want you to stop reading at the fourth verse. Whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises. How many receive a promise from God? I'm really looking for hands. How many in this place the Lord has ever told you anything? Read, mother.
That by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
Yes, go ahead.
And besides this,
yes,
given all diligence,
yes,
add to your faith virtue. Add to virtue knowledge.
Add to your faith virtue. Virtue. The purity of the motive behind. Can I just say that one more time? The purity of it and the motive behind it. Now somebody may be asking themselves right now, I wonder why haven't I really got that thing yet? Well, the Lord asked you a question this morning that he had me to go back to last night when I got back to the hotel. He said, you gotta check your motive for why you want something. See, a lot of us saying, I want a new car, I want a new house, but let's be honest about it. We have been struggling so long that the first thing we say is, you know what, I want God to give me a new car. Now, that's all right, but you know what, wait till I get this house. I know that nobody think I had nothing. They didn't think I'm going to ever get nothing, but child, wait till God give me this house. Honey, I'm going to show them something. I know they treat me like a dog at church, but baby, wait till I pull up in this car. I'm going to wait right here at the church turn out, and I'm going to pull my car right up in front of the door, and I'm just going to sit there. Watch what folks going to say when they see it. That's why you ain't got it, because your mother is wrong. Don't let me teach the day off you. You got people running here right now. I just want a new house. And when I get my new house, I got that faith. I'm going to write down everything I want in it. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to put me some white carpet. As soon as you get your house, people come to your house. Don't step on my carpet. Take off your shoes. I need to hear some socks. Don't sit on my couch. Don't knock over my leg. I need to get nobody to come here but snatch your people. You done lost your mind. That's the reason why you ain't got it. Because God knows your motive ain't right. It's supposed to be a house, not a shrine. Y'all, can I just teach? I know people like that. They give you a ride in their car. It's raining outside, honey. Wait, let me put some paper down. Child, I know you ain't eating that in my car. You ain't gonna drink that in my car. Get your head off my window. Don't put no piss on my car. Wait a minute, don't leave back on my seat.
呢，老妖灵谁能跟你拼？哦，妖灵啊，来抢抢抢抢，看到什么？A new car don't make you a woman of God. Driving a Mercedes don't make you a woman of God. When you got the right spirit, you can ride in a Jeep and still be anointed. And I don't care what you got the faith to believe God for. God is going to bless you. Watch this. He's going to bless you with what your spirit is ready to handle. I'm not going to get no amens in here. I remember when I first wanted a new car, I said I wanted a Mercedes.And I went to pastor and I said, Pastor, I said, I want a Mercedes. And I went in and I said, he said, well, what kind of, you sure you, I said, yes, sir, that's what I want. So he said to me, I tell you what, for right now, why don't you pick out another car? Now, see, right there, some of y'all would say, I don't know why she went and asked her pastor. He don't work. He ain't his money. I feel like you ought to buy what you want about. But see, I believe this way. And that is when you're single, your pastor should be your father. Amen, somebody?And see, what happened is, I went to my pastor, and I said to him, I said, I picked out another car. I said, I want that Toyota Celica. And at that time, Mother Pearson had the lights that come up in the front of it. And so I took a picture of the pastor, and I said, this is the kind of car I want. And in my mind, I saw myself driving down the highway with some gloves on, and the sunroof back in shades on. And I said, man, I'm gonna look hot in this car. I said, I want me a red one. So I took the picture there to pastor, and I said, I want this car. And pastor said, no, the Lord is telling me to tell you to get that Toyota Camry. I said, but pastor, that ain't, I don't like that car. That kind of car is like a family car. He said, well, ain't you a woman of God? He said, listen, he said, you got to watch your image. And so, you know, I was a little upset, but I went ahead and got the Camry. And then one day I let somebody use my car, and they hit my car and tore it up. And so the whole front end was tore up. And pastor came outside one day and saw my car. And he said, what happened to your car? I said, I let somebody use it. And they kind of got into an accident. He said, take it to the body shop. And when I took it over to work, he told me to take it at and went back to get it. I said, well, how much do I owe you? He said, your pastor paid for it. And when I went back to pastor, he said, see, when you are under my rule and my government, it obligates me to help you when you fall into a crack. But if you go out there and get something on your own, when it gets turned around, you own your own. Y'all ain't gonna let me teach today. I feel this. See, I feel that thing. And you don't know the power of being under proper leadership. Because it helps to govern your spirit. And a lot of stuff we think we're ready for, we're not ready for it. Now, what does it say, Mother? Now, watch this. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Watch this. Read that, Mother.
And to virtue knowledge.
And to virtue knowledge. Are we going somewhere today? And to virtue knowledge. Some of y'all said, I want a car, and I want me a Mercedes, and I want me a house. You have not received that because you don't have the knowledge that it takes to understand what you are about to buy. Come on, somebody. When the pump breaks down, you can call the landlord. All you're thinking about is furniture. You're not thinking about the responsibility. And see, some of y'all saying, one day I'm going to be a millionaire. You don't even know how to manage $500. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You don't even pay no tithes. Why is God going to trust you and make you a bigger thief than you already are? I wish I had a real church in here today. If God were to give some of us $1 million right now, 6 months later, you would be broke. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because everything you got is on your back. You got to have a Gucci purse. You got to have Chanel stuff. You got to have Gucci glasses. You ain't got sense enough to understand that if I invest money, money will come back to me. You didn't have the knowledge to have $1 million. So God will bless you with a $700 job and teach you how to master that. And when you have mastered that, then you graduate to more money. You just don't jump into money.
Y'all ain't gonna lose. Hey.
See, just let me tell you this. Whatever it is, you are believing God for. Watch this. Study that thing.
house. Go and get some information about the neighborhood you say God getting ready to move you into. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Study what it means to take care of a house. Study what it means to own your own ice cream shop. It's more than soup and cones, baby. You got to know the rules. You got to know the highs and the lows and the high season and the low season. Stop believing God for a fantasy. You're going to have to work. Yes, the Bible said, you got to listen, without works, faith is inevitable. You're not going to get anything, but you got to work at it. Some of y'all treat faith like it's a magic trick. I'm going to click my heels together, and then I'm going to have it. That's not faith. Read the Bible, mother, right quick.
And to knowledge, temperance.
Temperance. Temperance. Temperance. Can I say that again? Temperance. Some of us spend too much. Some of us go too much. We don't use the wisdom about stuff. Y'all, can I just say this to us today? You got to watch everything you do. The Bible said, acknowledge him in all of your ways, and he shall direct your path. When you get ready to do something, you ought to ask the Lord, is this your will? Because anything that is God's will, when the devil attacks it, he will bring you out of it. If it's something you got yourself into, a lot of stuff you call faith is foolishness. I'm not going to get no amens right there. You don't take your rent money. Y'all ain't going to say nothing right now. Y'all ain't going to say nothing to me. Well, I just felt led not to pay my rent today. I just felt led to just go on out of town somewhere. I just kind of felt the need of the Lord that I ain't going to pay my bill right now. I'm just going to go on and take it and do something else. And meantime, I got the faith. Well, you know what? If your faith is going up against your integrity, then it is not faith. Because faith does not contradict integrity. If you promise somebody, if you give me a phone, I will pay my phone bill. Then pay your phone bill before you get your nails done. Pay your phone bill before you get your feet done. Pay your phone bill. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Before you buy a TV, pay your rent. Your integrity cannot contradict your faith. It's awful quiet in here today. I said it's awful quiet in here today. He's going to back some of you up when you get back home. You need to sit down and write out your bills and write out your income and stop all this foolishness. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. I'm not getting no amens right now. See, you don't want to shout over the truth right here. But I'm going to tell you something. If you can't say yes to this, listen, you won't keep on being in a hole until you stop giving God an argument in your mind about discipline and character. You can't speak in tongues and not have integrity. what's coming. Read the Bible. To temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness. Read on. And to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. Now watch this. For if these things be in you, watch this. Everything that you are asking God for, if it cannot be used with temperance, brotherly kindness, virtue, knowledge, it is not of God. I'm going to say that again, because God is not just blessing you. Your blessing is not for you. Watch this, 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 watch this. Every time God blessed me with something or to do something, he always said to me, watch this, this is a loan. Every time I got a car, when I got my first car, he said to me, I'm giving you this car the day I got it. He said, but this car doesn't belong to you. He said, this car is going to get you to the Mercedes. God, I wish I had a church in here to believe that. So 1 week after I had it, see, God give me to retrain somebody's spirit in here today, because you got to look at everything that you got as if it's only temporary in your house. You got to look at your furniture and say, God, who am I going to get this to, because this ain't my dream furniture. I wish I had a church in here today. God, who am I going to get these clothes to, because this ain't my final wardrobe. See, when you get stuff to hold on to, then you will never get to your real blessing. Because God said, if I can trust you to release this, then I can give you something else. And every time you release something, you graduate to another level. Did somebody say, I'm getting ready to graduate? Oh, y'all ain't saying it like you mean. I'm getting ready to graduate. I'm getting ready to throw out some furniture. I'm getting ready to give away some cars. Come on, get somebody. You want to tell God, every time you put something in my hand, I'm going to give it away. I'm going to give it away. Because every time I give it, I get again. 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 Watch this. He said to me, he said, take the white car and give the white car to a sister in the church. Now, this is what I do. I said, Holy Ghost, I hear you. Now watch this. Some of y'all in here right now, you may not have a vehicle, and you say to yourself, but why don't I have a car? I don't want to say I have a car. See, first of all, watch this. God got to train your spirit how to walk and be satisfied. See, the reason why you ain't got it yet, because you're walking, but you're complaining. I'm going to tell you how to get your blessing. You get your blessing when you get on that bus stop saying, God, I thank you for being here. When I get enough, I'm going to give this away. And God said, that ain't what I said. He said, the same God that got you the first one can get you the second one. But the reason why you don't want to trust me, because you know in order to get the second one, you're going to have to keep yourself clean like you did when you got the first one, y'all ain't said. See, that's why some of y'all don't want to go no higher, because you know God ain't going to give you nothing until you clean your mind up and clean your spirit up. Come on here, somebody. I gave the car away, and I walked for about 9 to 10 months. I said, okay, Lord. I said, what are you doing here? And at that time, I was coming into the office in my church of being the prophetess. I said, God, people are going to say, she got so much faith, such a prophet as she walking. And I was thumbing rods and stuff. And I was, you know, I said, God, I'm embarrassed. And he said, you ain't embarrassed, you proud. I'm trying to break your spirit. He said, you thought you was all that when you was in your car with your leather seats. Now you got to ride on the church bus. And all of y'all, they said, y'all don't want... Yeah. See, every now and then, God will put your stuff in check. Every now and then, he'll bless you. And then he'll check out your spirit to see where you are with all that saying. He'll go and let you get a neat and walk the suit. But then he'll tell you to lay on the floor one Sunday just to find out where your spirit is.
Sitting on the showroom floor, he comes back and says, a doctor bought this car.
and it was too much clout for him, so he brought it back. And according to my paperwork, we got to take almost $40,000 off the car. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Now watch this. The day I got the car, I got in the car, driving the car, crying, thanking God for my car, and the Holy Ghost interrupted my tears and said, this ain't your car. So stop crying. I said, this ain't my car. This is the president of our women's department. He said, it's her car. I said, well, he said, no, you are holding this car. Keep it serviced. Keep it clean. Don't get no dents on it. It's her car. Then the Holy Ghost said, give it to him. And then I said, when I get another one, he said, no, it's time for another pride check. Y'all ain't saying that.
He's talking in his sleep.
I said, you ain't ready for marriage. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm gonna have somebody in here. You ain't ready for marriage. And some of you married women in here, you gotta be careful. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You all at home got my tapes and Bishop tapes all loud. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Your husband ain't even saved. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Every time the church door open, you jumping in it. You better have some wisdom. You better tell that man if you want to win him the church, get up and tell him, baby, I ain't going this side. He said, boy, you said no. I want to stay home with you. See, let me help you with something. That's the reason why you ever got your man. And that's why the worship, that's why some of y'all look at your husband's friend that he's been playing around on you with, and your girlfriend said, girl, don't worry about it. And I saw in the grocery store, she a big old somebody. Got old nasty Jerry Curry. Child, she, you look better than her. Girl, she don't look nothing like you. And wait. Now, here's the ultimate trick statement right here. He being tricked by the devil. Girl, the devil got that man. The devil, he tired of your big legs and your shaky hope. And you ever cooking for him? You ever running bath water? You ever been making biscuits? Y'all ain't saying that. You ever ministering to that man while you shouting in church with your cute self? Y'all don't want me to teach you today, but I'm going to teach you. When you get home on this conference, turn the tapes off. Don't go home blabbing your tapes. Go home and minister to your husband. Y'all don't want me to teach today. Y'all don't want me to teach today. He picked you up a man for you. Wait a minute. You don't mind if I stick this tape in and do it. Whatever I say. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. He said, baby, how was your trip? Ooh, it was blessed. Oh, it was blessed. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I said, y'all ain't saying nothing. See, some of y'all said, pray for me, because my husband is the devil. No. No, the Bible said that he's sanctified by a sanctified wife, not a stupid wife. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Be tired of your tongues and you ain't got dinner ready. Be tired of your tongues and the kids' clothes ain't washed. Y'all ain't going to talk back here. I know you're mad, but ain't nobody mad but the devil. Who stick all your tongues and you're sticking in tongues and stretched all out in the basement? Talking about you in intercession and ain't cooked your dinner and ain't cleaned your house. Y'all don't want me to teach in here, but the devil is a liar. He's not going to trick you no more. Your warfare is not your husband. Your warfare is you. Your warfare is your integrity. Your warfare is your character. I'm not getting no amens today. I ain't getting no amens today. I said, I ain't getting no amens today. Running around with all your single girlfriends. Why you think they single? But it's all right. I came to kill anything that's not my God. We gotta send you home right. Now you ain't going home high this year. Come on, get somebody. You ain't going home in the clouds this year. You're going home walking in authority. You're going home walking in integrity. You gotta go home and change some stuff. Some of y'all have to go home and clean some mess out of your life. Clean your house out. Everybody here size 22 for over 14 away, it don't fit no more. Now they said nothing here. Are we going home and do a check on our womanhood? Because if you're a woman of God, you ain't selling nothing. You know what? Listen, when you sell stuff, you put it on display. You ain't gonna put nothing on display. You ain't selling nothing. You're gonna stand still and wait on the Lord. The Lord already knows who your husband is. And if I tell you something, you still got so much residue left on you from the world. You're not getting your right mind that you tell y'all right now. A woman leaned over last night on the pulpit and said, "Prophetess." And she was so stupid. "Have a nice talk with your husband." I said, "No." And she said, "Are you sure?" I said, "No, ma'am." And she said, "Oh." So she looked over at me. A couple of people complimented me how good I look. And I said, "Thank you." When I sat down, the Lord said, "You look good, but I ain't through with you, so I'm getting to see you." He said, "I ain't got nobody for you right now." So y'all don't think God will rebuke you like that. He said, "Uh-huh, got cute hairstyle, all that, but you ain't ready." That was true. See, I'm going to tell you, you ain't ready as long as you can hear that thing in your flesh saying, "I want to get married. I want to get married. I just want to get married. Ooh, I'm just burning up, Jesus. I just want to be gospel." You ain't ready. You ain't ready. He said, "Because your motive is still saints." See, the Lord allowed me to know that when you really get ready for marriage, when you really get ready for marriage, when God finally brings your husband, watch this, you ought to look up at him and say, "Oh, shoot."
Serve them. Thou shalt not hearken unto the words
Yes. Even unto the other end of the earth.
What does it say to you?
Thou shalt not consent unto him. Nor hearken unto him.
But what she can do?
Neither shall thine eyes pity him.
Neither
shall thy spare.
Yes.
Neither shall thy conceal him.
Read it.
But thou shalt surely kill him.
Got it. That means if your mama said, let's see.
On over to the disco, Shandabasi.
See, y'all regards our friends as friends. When a demon is talking about a young relative, you are going to look at that devil right in the face and say, devil, you are lying. I cast you out in the name of Jesus. It took me too long to get here. You don't know how many times I've stayed up at night. You don't know how many meals I turned down. You don't know where I've been. You don't know how hard I had to pray and shout. And I'm not getting ready to let nothing get in my way. But I command you in the name of Jesus to get behind me. I'm killing everything. Turn around and tell the people, kill it. Come on, kill it. Oh, y'all gotta say that you mean to kill it. Take that grin off your face and say, kill it. Kill that mustache. Kill that lying spirit. Kill that gossip and cheat. Kill it. Kill it. Kill that nicotine habit. You're going home clean. You're going home steadfast. You're going home unmovable. Y'all ain't said, tell somebody, I shall not be moved. Y'all don't listen. You don't know what I see in this place today. I said, God said this was going to be the last time that you come to another conflict and the devil steal what you get when you get back home. He ain't taking nothing else from you. I wish I had somebody here. Give it praise.